Television 97. We've got some wonderful sponsors, of course, that are making the game possible here today. Once again, it is Tishomingo County and Mooreville about ready to play. It's also brought to you by First American National Bank. They invite you to stop by and see Aaron Holt at First American in Iuka for all your banking needs. First American has four convenient offices in Tishomingo County waiting to assist you. Had some folks asking about the internet. As of right now, the internet seems to be okay, so y'all stay with us, and hopefully we'll not have any internet issues here in Mooreville. I understand there are some AT&T issues back around Red Bay and the Belmont area, but right now, hopefully that's not going to affect us here in Mooreville. We're on the hot spot. And if you're out here joining us on the broadcast, they're doing final preparations of the field. We wanted to go ahead live because we told you the game was starting at 7 o'clock tonight, so we're just about ready to get her going here in just a minute. I want to, first of all, say how much we appreciate the wonderful folks here at Mooreville. They are outstanding folks. I always enjoy coming here to do whatever sport it might be, whether it's football, basketball, baseball, or softball, and or any sport. They always make us feel welcome, and we really do appreciate that. Once again, we're live right now, and we're double-checking to make sure we've got all of our settings correctly as far as our stream is concerned. But if you're out there joining us on the broadcast, we invite you to share this link right now. The only way we can get it out there is for you to share it. And I understand some folks here at Mooreville is already sharing that broadcast out. So if you're watching in Mooreville, make sure you share this link so your friends can enjoy some Tish County and Mooreville sports here on WRMG. By the way, if you do have YouTube, I'm assuming our internet holds up, you can get on your smart television set and go to YouTube and just search Jack Ivy, J-A-C-K, last name Ivy, I-V-Y. You can watch it on the big screen in high definition. So hopefully we'll try that out tonight. If not, you can just watch it on Facebook. We'll also have it on Twitter and Twitch as well. But right now, everything seems to be rocking right along here in the big city of Mooreville. Our game sponsors today is Brooks Grocery, family-owned and operated since 2009. Also, Tishomingo Connect, high-speed internet coming to every single household in Tishomingo County. By Iuka Animal Clinic, Dr. James Perkins on Highway 25 South, 423-3470. Also, A&W Septic Tank and Pumping, 307 Constitution Drive, Iuka. You can call Jimmy at 424-9884. Also, your full-service plumbing company, and everything's at an affordable price. When you deal with those guys. Williams Service Center, Todd Williams, full service, of course, out on Quitman at 1112 Quitman. You can call him at 423-2119. Once again, that's Todd Williams at Williams Service Center on a broadcast here today on WRMG. We're actually going to, while we're talking to you here, we're going to type up and actually change the name of the instead of just saying Jack Ivy Broadcasting, which is something normal that just pops up there, we're going to go ahead and type in Tishomingo County versus Mooreville. So if somebody comes up there, they'll know they're at the right place. Honored to have you on the broadcast. Once again, a big division game here tonight on WRMG, TV 12, and TV 97. We told you it was senior night. They recognize all the seniors here. And, of course, we got to watch that. We didn't record it. They recorded it themselves here. So, once again, keep it right here to WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Tishomingo County versus Mooreville. I've about got it typed up here. Today's game, of course, brought to you by Dr. Cameron Bunch at the North Mississippi Medical Center, Iuka. You can call him at 423-6014. To schedule that appointment. Also, Cream and Sugar Cafe, located historic downtown Iuka at 100 West Front Street, serving a full breakfast and lunch. The menu, of course, 7 to 3 daily, closed on Tuesday and Wednesday. Whether it's dine-in, carry-out, curbside, local delivery, 662-593-3498. Also, Williams Pest Control Insulation on a broadcast, Tyler Wooten, 662-454-3383, whether it's walling and insulation in the attic space, hanging in the insulation walls, termite treatments, pre-treatments for new construction, or just general pest control, they take care of you at Williams Pest Control. Also, tonight's game is also brought to you by Gina McNatt, your Tishomingo County tax collector, on the broadcast. Do me a favor, if you've not shared this broadcast, please share it right now. Let your friends know the ball game is on the air. We're going to have the starting lineups and, I guess, the national anthem coming up here shortly. Live in Mooreville on this, the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Today's game also brought to you by Atkins Electrical and Plumbing Supply for all your electrical and plumbing needs. Call 662-424-9884. Also, Brandon Presley, your public service commissioner. By also Carly Carmen, your attorney at 131 South Fulton Street, Iuka. Call her at 662-593-3079, a small firm with a big heart. They do real estate law, business law, adoptions, estate planning, maybe nonprofit and charity formations if you need that. Visit them online at nextdoorlawyer.com. Also, B&J's Grocery in the big city of Burnsville. Good luck to all the area teams from Tishomingo County from, of course, B&J's Grocery, your hometown store supporting hometown teams. Also, Captain Ryan Glover of Tishomingo County Sheriff's Department on a broadcast tonight. Animals Choice Vet Clinic, Dr. Brad Nunley, Dr. Jennifer Tucker. Wes, want to wish the Braves good luck to you tonight. Also, Josh McNett, your circuit court clerk by Harwell Parts and Service, located on Quitman Street. Call Chad at 423-9892 for all your parts and supply needs. Also, Dr. Scott Seegers, nurse practitioners Sarah Cooley, Jessica Glover, Blake McCauley, here to serve the hometown folks at 423-1000. That's the number to call for an appointment. Also, Hometown Pizza in Iuka and Burnsville, downtown Iuka, located at 509 Battleground Drive. Call them at 662-593-3036, and they're open 7 days a week. Now offering that crustless pizza for all the dieters out there that don't like all the extra bread. They got the 20-inch party pizzas. You might want to check out one for the big game here tonight. The umpires are talking with the coaches at the batter's box right now, and we're getting closer and closer to getting this one underway here tonight on WRMG. Also, today's game brought to you by Gatlin's Pharmacy, home of the Tishomingo County's best cost savings program. It's a 340B program, and they got that, of course, at Gatlin's to save you hundreds of dollars. We're going to turn it over to our public address announcer for the starting lineups for Tishomingo County. Dylan Kirk. Blake Counts will bat second. Spence Kaufman will bat third. He'll be at shortstop tonight. Gage Tack at a bat fourth. He is at the catcher slot tonight. Third baseman batting fifth will be Jackson Moore. Chandler Williams will bat sixth, number 12. He'll be the DH tonight. Batting seventh will be Ashton Brown. He'll be on the mound pitching for Tish County tonight. He'll be followed by Chase Hopkins, who will be out in center field. He'll wear 18. Batting number nine, second baseman Trey Williams. And the first baseman will be Jackson Gray and the rest of the Tish County Braves. Now we'll have the starting lineups for the ball club from Mooreville on this, the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Then we'll, I think, have the national anthem. Jacob Scott, he'll be at shortstop. Mason Gillentine. He'll be behind the plate. On the mound is J.W. Armistead. Mason McMillan will be at second base. Center fielder will be Judd Files. Taylor Hussey will be in left field. Brennan Gray will be in right. Eli Rushing will be at first base. And Luke Carpenter will be at third base. Head coach is Derek Thompson. Adam Hill, Drew Wheeler, and Adam Hood are the assistants. Of course, Tisch County coached by Austin Marlin, Bobby Felker, Daniel Stewart, and Scott Marlin are the assistants. Once again, it's Tishomingo County and Mooreville about ready to go live here on WRMG. We're going to have our national anthem, and then we'll have the start of tonight's game. Late start on some of these high school games. This one here getting started, of course, after 7 o'clock. And now the national anthem. And the national anthem. We've had the starting lineups. We're about ready to get underway. Once again, we're live in Mooreville on this, the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Today's game brought to you by Prey Pottery and Heavenly Yogurt. And, of course, good luck to the Braves here today. They're located, of course, at 115 South Fulton Street in Iuka. Call Prey Pottery, Heavenly Yogurt, 424-0202. Also making this game possible tonight as they include Tishomingo County Electric Power. TVA will come do an energy audit that's called the TVA's E-Program. They still offer a rebate on the hot water heaters, whether you switch from gas to electric or electric to electric. They're also focusing on providing efficient, reliable service to all our Tishomingo County members. And good luck to the Tishomingo County teams from Tishomingo County Electric Power Association. Thank you, Tia Boone, your Tishomingo County Farm View agent on our broadcast at 1112 Maria Lane in Iuka. Don't forget, when service is local, service is better. Go with the home team. Go with Farm Bureau. 423-6151. On the mound pitching is J.W. Armistead for Coach Derek Thompson's Mooreville Troopers. Of course, Tishomingo County will have on the mound tonight Ashton Brown. Braves will bat here in the top of the first inning. Leading off will be Dylan Kirk, followed by Blake Count, Spence Kaufman, Gage Tackett, Jackson Moore, Chandler Williams, Ashton Brown, Chase Hopkins, Trey Williams, and Jackson Gray all on the roster for the ball club here tonight. Today's game also brought to you by Casey Lott, your personal injury attorney. He's the owner of the largest personal injury firm in Northeast Mississippi with attorneys licensed in Mississippi, Alabama, and Tennessee. Casey and his team of attorneys specialize in personal injury, also pharmaceutical product liability cases. Call Casey Lott for all your legal needs. Also, Peyton Cummings, your Tishomingo County Chancery Clerk, is on our broadcast here tonight. Northeast Mississippi Community College, 1-800-555-2154. By Iuka Discount Drugs on our broadcast. Call 423-9039. They offer the ultimate prescription management solution with their free 101 one-pack program. They also offer free delivery, vaccines, and a 340B program. And the first pitch is in there for a strike. One strike count, and we're live once again on WRMG. That pitch is another strike. Appreciate Rhonda Crum out there with us, Brother Billy Nichols, David, Pam Leatherwood, Carol Barnes, Sam Hawthorne out there. As that ball gets away, it'll be one ball, two strikes. Left-handed batter, right-handed pitcher, and here's the pitch on the way. Ball outside to even up the count. Two quick strikes, couple of balls here, and we're even on the count, two balls and two strikes. This is Dylan Kirk. He's the left fielder. Thank you, Ricky Lambert, for joining our broadcast. And there's the pitch. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. What's Mr. Armistead throwing over there? 91's top. Hard throwing right-hander. Here's the pitch on the way. Swing and a ground ball to the shortstop. Shortstop tries to field it, but leaves it behind, and Tishomingo County has got a base runner down at first base. Score that one, E6. Thank you, Brittany Gable Sparks, for sharing this broadcast. There's David Oaks with us. Thank everybody for sharing our broadcast. We want to get a lot of folks watching, not only in Tishomingo County, but also here in the Lee County area, watching these Mooreville Troopers and the Tish County Braves. Runner at first with one out. This will be number five. This is Spence Kaufman as Blake counts. Reach base on an error. Spence Kaufman, he's a signee with Southeast Louisiana down in Hammond, Louisiana, to play baseball. Outstanding basketball player for the Tish County Braves this season. Let us know what our broadcast looks like and sounds like wherever you're at. Send us a little message here. And if you're watching on YouTube, I want you to pick your phone up and come over to where we're at on Facebook, and because you can't send me a message there on YouTube, but you can send me a message here and say, hey, Jack, I'm watching it on YouTube, and you can tell me what it looks like there as well. Three balls and one strike to Spence Kaufman. Runner on first. Tackett is on deck, and the pitch on the way. Swing. And a foul ball down the right side. And that ball is going to get out of play. Tishomingo County and Belmont play Saturday in softball and baseball. We're trying to figure out how in the world to do all the things we got to do. So if you want a good Saturday coming up, Belmont and Tish County play softball and baseball at Tish County. Three balls, one strike, one out. Kaufman ready for the pitch from Armistead. It's inside, ball four. So the Braves quickly have two base runners against the ball club from Mooreville. Gage Tackett will be your batter. Gage Ware is a number three. He'll bat with runners at first and second and nobody out. Today's game brought to you by Nunley Trucking Company. Herman and Terrell. Harold, thank you so much. Mac Wom in your Tishomingo County corner on a broadcast. And the pitch on the way. Tackett takes the ball. Also to broadcast today is David Wayne Crum, your Tishomingo County tax assessor, and also Mid-South Rehab. You know, you do have a choice when it comes to your therapy. The therapy team at North Mississippi Medical Center is there on target for physical, occupational, and speech therapy. And there's another ball outside. You can call them for an appointment or for more information, 423-4058. And don't forget, for your convenience, the swing bed program, the perfect place to recover after surgery or injury. We're talking Mid-South Rehab at the North Mississippi Medical Center in Iuka. 2-0 count, make it 3-0. Armistead struggling a little bit here in the top of the first inning. He's got one out, but runners at first and second in a 3-1 count here to the cleanup hitter for the Braves. And the pitch, ball four. Bases are loaded for Tishomingo County. So Tish County off to a good start here. Hadn't put any runs on the board yet. We'll have a courtesy runner. I believe number 19 is going to be running down at first. That is going to be Ashton Hall running for Tishomingo County. And this will be number 22, Jackson Moore. He's a freshman, third baseman. And Jackson hits one off the handle, and it's off the pitcher's glove. He falls down, a run scores, and everybody's going to be safe. And now it's thrown away at third base, and the runner will stay down at third. So Tishomingo County is on board. And you'd have to score with that one, an infield hit there for Jackson Moore. And Tishomingo County is on the board and leads 1-0 over the Troopers. Still only one out. The base is loaded. Number 12, the DH, is Chandler Williams. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a foul ball. Appreciate all you folks that have shared this. We need to get more to share it so we can get more folks watching our broadcast. There's the pitch on the way. It is ball. One ball, one strike. We're on Facebook. We're on YouTube. We're on Twitter. Mikey Shea's watching. Wonder if we could get old Mikey Shea to share this broadcast. And there is a pitcher hit by a batter hit by a pitch. And guess what? That scores another run for Tish County. Base is still loaded with one out and two runs across the board for Tishomingo County. Now Mooreville has called a timeout. They'll head to the mound. So we got a timeout. Tishomingo County leads in the top of the first by a score of 2-0. Mooreville meeting on the mound, and down the third base side is Tishomingo County. Beating down there with Coach Marla. Brittany Gable Sparks says it looks great. Don't forget you can watch it. Sean Bullard and Katie Hogue out there sharing a broadcast. Remember, you can go to my YouTube channel. Just go to YouTube and search Jack Ivy. You can watch it in high definition there. Of course, you can't communicate with me without coming back over to Facebook to let me know that you're watching, but we wish you'd do that. I think you'll be excited how good it looks on YouTube. And if you'll share this broadcast, we surely would appreciate it. We have some wonderful sponsors, of course, that are making this game possible today. And they include folks like Hometown Pizza there in Burnsville, the Tiffin Motorhomes in Red Bay, Belmont, Iuka, Belmont Medical Clinic, and the pitch on the way. Showing a bunt, it's foul. Heather Edmondson is down in the big city of Belmont, 454-3401. Her and her staff does a wonderful job, and for the best medical care for you and your family, definitely worth the drive to Belmont Medical Clinic and Heather Edmondson. Y'all know her better half, Mr. Shannon Edmondson. Thank you, Miss Heather. And there is a wild pitch. A run will score easily for Tishomingo County. So Tish County now will have runners at second and third, and now lead 3-0 over the ball club from Moore. Appreciate Plaza Lane's Premier Bowling Alley in Corinth on a broadcast, 2001 East Shiloh Road. Call them at 286-8105. Visit them online at bowlcorinth.com. And, yes, they do have leagues for all skill levels. Perfect birthday destination as well. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. And Ashton Brown is down on strikes. He's the pitcher for Tish County today. This will bring up Chase Hopkins. I'm having to lean over to look at my roster. So three runs are in, runners at second and third now with two out. Ball inside. Number 18, the batter, Chase Hopkins, the center fielder. Appreciate Triple D's bucket service right there in Iuka. Barney Brandon and Dustin Dick swinging a miss to even the count. One ball, one strike, two out. Braves lead 3-0. You can see that down at the bottom of the screen there. And the pitch on the way is a ball. Y'all let me know what it looks like and sounds like. Send us a little message. We always like good feedback. And, of course, we hope you're going to say it sounds good as well. We got some folks saying it looks good. Hopefully the audio is good for us. We want you to have a good quality broadcast. There is a strike. Good pitch there by Armistead. Speaking of Armistead, There he is right there on the mound, right-hander. Hit 91 earlier. Don't know if that's what he's can throw or higher. Has he ever hit higher than 91? 93. Is he hit 93 today? 93 has been his highest today. That is smoking it. Two balls, two strikes, and two outs. Deuce is wild here in Mooreville. And the pitch on the way. Just missing. 3-2. Three balls, two strikes, two outs. Top of the first inning, 3-0 Tishomingo County, all brought to you by Burnsville Tire, Mr. Ethan Morris, your owner. Located on Highway 72 West, 427-9308 in Burnsville. And there is ball four, and the bases are loaded again for Tishomingo County. Trey Williams, the second baseman, will now bat. Gary Ivey joining us. Carol Berryman out there with us. Got a few more folks. More, I think, watching on YouTube and maybe Twitter, but several on Facebook Live. Hopefully you've found us. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. Armistead trying to get out of the inning without giving up any more. He's got the bases loaded right now for Tish County with a two-strike count with two out. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. Armistead gets out of the inning. And Tishomingo County strands the bases loaded, but put three on the board and lead 3-0 as we go to the bottom of the first inning. Heading to the mound, pitching for Tishomingo County will be Ashton Brown. And, of course, behind the plate will be Gage Tackett. Once again, this is Tishomingo County Braves Baseball live on WRMG. We also got Belmont and East Union Softball on our Facebook tonight as well. Today's game brought to you by Sonic and Iucan Belmont, your morning drink stop. Large soft drinks starting at 99 cents. Happy hours, of course, 2 to 4 daily. Half-price soft drinks, slushies, and teas. We need you to download that app. I think you can take advantage of some more wonderful savings. 454-3070 in Belmont, in Iuka, 423-3100. Today's game brought to you by your hometown Piggly Wiggly and Ace Hardware in Iuka. Ronnie Cook, your modern women agent. By Sitch Trading Company, your Branson dealer. Also, First American National Bank is on our broadcast. Don't forget Brenda Kennedy at First American in Burnsville are always eager to assist you with all your banking needs. Stop in at First American National Bank in Burnsville location and let them help. Don't forget at First American National Bank, you'll get that hometown feel with a high-tech touch. First American since 1964. Well, we'll see what the Mooreville Troopers can do as we move to this bottom of the first inning. Blair Holt. I know one thing. The pitcher for Tishomingo County needs to make sure that ball has made it down to second base before he turns his back, because it sure looked like that Gage Tackett's throw down to second whizzed right by his ears. I heard some folks down below saying, woo, it was that close. Thank you, Iuka Animal Clinic, Dr. James Perkins. 4-2-3-34-70. And here is the pitch to start the bottom of the first. Tish County leads 3-0. Pitch outside. Two balls, no strikes. Tish County starting a left-hander today. Hey, Blair Holt. Gary Ivey out there with us. Carol Berryman. There's Emily Newton Comer out there saying, let's go Troopers. Thank you, Miss Emily. We appreciate all you Troopers out there. Maybe they'll share it and get some more folks to enjoy the broadcast here. Three oh count and the pitch on the way. Here's a strike on the corner. Want top notch internet no matter where you live in Tishomingo County? Tishomingo Connect is here for you, 423-3646. Everybody in Tishomingo County will have access. And as you can hear, the Mooreville folks down below questioning these last two pitches here. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a right back to the pitcher. What a catch by the pitcher. So that'll be one out. We go to the bottom of the first inning. So Jacob Scott lines out to the pitcher. This will bring up Mason Gillentine. Thank you, Toby Hall out there, Sean Bullard, and others sharing this broadcast. Mason Gillentine is the catcher, and he back to the pitcher, over to the first baseman. And guess what? The first baseman, I don't know what happened down there, dropped the ball. It was the easiest play of the century. And the pitcher just flipped it over there, and I don't know where it fell out of the glove or what, but it is a base runner and an error on Tishomingo County. Thank you. Miss Emily, if you don't care, Miss Emily Newton Comer, make sure you share this broadcast. It is okay to say go Troopers. I know the Mooreville folks and Tish County folks can cheer for their teams out there and be nice. We're just hoping you're enjoying the ball game. Swing and a miss. This is number six batting. J.W. Armistead, he is the pitcher. He trails of the game 3-0, his Troopers do. He's got a runner down at first with one out and the pitch on the way. Ball outside. And the throw over to first got away, and now the runner will head down to second base. He makes the turn. He's heading over to third, and he slides in there safely. So another two-base error, or another error. This is two bases. He got on base on an error, and now a throw-in error. And the runner's over at third now with one out. And Armistead with a chance to drive him in. We'll have a courtesy runner over at third base for Gillentine. Here's Brother David Conley checking in our broadcast. One ball, one strike, and one out. Tishomingo County having a meeting on the mound. There's your courtesy runner down at third base there. That is number 13, I believe. We'll tell you who he is in just a minute. And yeah, there's a pitch for a ball. Caden Carroll, the courtesy runner down there. Two balls and one strike to Armistead. One out and the pitch. Strike call. Appreciate A&W Septic Tank and Pumping at 307 Constitution Drive. Call Jimmy 424-9884. Also your full service plumbing company as well. Ball outside. Three balls, two strikes. We offer anything from a trenchless sewer pipe replacement to fixing a simple faucet leak, all at affordable prices. Once again, that's A&W Septic Tank. And there's a foul back on the 3-2 count. Once again, don't forget Tishomingo Connect, 423-3646. And also Brooks Grocery. You can't beat that friendly service. There are 128 made right here recipes. You can get them all at Brooks Grocery in Iuka. And there is a foul ball. Of course, Brooks has been there since 2009. And there's ball four for Armistead. So runners at first and third with one out. No runs are in for Mooreville, but Tishomingo County leads 3-0. But Mooreville trying to squeeze it back a little bit and get some of those runs back. There's Toby Hall. Say, let's go Braves. Miss Anita Mitchell out there with us. Thank you, Williams Service Center. Tied 4-2-3, 21-19. Honored to have you on the broadcast here live in Mooreville tonight on this, the Ivy Broadcasting. What a great place to broadcast from. Press box right here behind the plate. You see, I've got my good shot. I'm in the dry. If it's raining or winds blowing the chance of you can't afford to get a bunch of a few thousand dollars worth of equipment damage, and they got wonderful facilities here. We're hoping one of these days they'll get us a press box behind home plate for Belmont and Tisch County in baseball, and also one for Tisch County softball. Got one at Belmont. Awesome facilities for the softball there. Really doing a lot of upgrading, and of course they did that when they built the new softball park at Belmont. But it's a nice place to broadcast. Makes it easy on us old folks. Here's the 1-0 pitch. I'm surprised that maybe Mooreville hadn't tried to get that runner down to second, get him out of a force-out situation. There's Dr. Cameron Bunge, North Mississippi Medical Center, 423-6014. Also, Cream and Sugar Cafe, 662-593-3498. Come see us. And there's a strike on the corner, 2-2. Well, they got 3-1 up there, but that may be right. I don't know. I thought he hadn't put up that last strike, but maybe he did. 3-1's when it's on the board, so we'll go with that. Here's the pitch, strike call, as the batter throws his bat away, thinking he's walking easily. Three balls, two strikes, one out. Runner at first and third with one out. Tisch County needs a strikeout here. There's the pitch, swing, and a pop a mile high. It's deep, way back there. And, folks, it's not only deep, it's out of the park. A three-run homer. I thought he might have got under it a little bit too much, but that's not the case. A three-run homer for that man right there, folks. And we've got a tie ball game. So Mason McMillan takes it deep. That is a great hit, that by the young man, to tie the ball game up. Guess we need to put that up on our scoreboard here. This is live coverage of Tishomingo County and the ball club from Mooreville. I'm Jack Ivey, live here from WRMG. Thank you, Lexi Kennedy, checking in with us. Christina Thorne, also Ginger Pinnell with us out there. Judd Fowles now the batter. So what about Mason McMillan taking that one deep for a three-run homer to tie it up here in the bottom of the first? Ashton Brown, the left-hander on the mound, pitch inside. And the pitch, swinging a foul back. Scoreboard back right here. I'm trying to do something else on this computer, if y'all bear it with me. I was trying to turn on the lighted keyboard, and I finally got it on so I could see it. It's kind of dark here in the press box. Of course, we got the lights off. We can see really better. 2-2 pitch, and that is three balls and two strikes. Judd Fowles the batter. Taylor Hussey on deck with nobody on here. One out. And there's ball four. So another base runner for the Mooreville Troopers. So both clubs threatening, or not threatening, but struggling here in the first inning. Mooreville 3, Tishomingo County 3. Mooreville's got a runner at first with just one out. Make sure you share this link for me. Anybody been watching on, anybody watching on YouTube and high definition on your big screen TV? If you are, won't you come back and let me know what it looks like? There's Christina Reagan checking out. Ronnie Livingston, that is, we had it lined up to do that, and the guy that was supposed to do the play-by-play had a conflict or something, and we were not able to do that. We were going to be like in three places or so at one time here, and, of course, at two Belmont places. And actually, this morning, was going to be at four places, and they canceled the Tish County and that rather Red Bay and Mooreville softball game, so... We wish it was there, Mr. Runny, so you could be able to see the game, but we're not, and I apologize. We'd already committed to being here tonight. Can't do them all, but we're trying to do as many as possible. Think about it. We do three different teams, and when you talk about football, basketball, you know, you're talking about three teams. But when you do spring sports, you're talking about six teams. You got two from each location, so kind of makes it a little bit more difficult. Three balls and one strike. And the toss over to first, runner back. Taylor Hussey, the batter here. Get you a close-up of Mr. Taylor. Left-hander's ready to go for the Braves. He'll bring it to the plate, and it's a ball four. So Mooreville now will have two runners on and nobody out. It's amazing, not blaming nobody, but it's amazing what errors will turn into trouble. Tish County had an error at first and then a throwing error over there to try to pick him off, and it was a two-base error, so they sent him over to – he was on third real easy. There's a shot down the line. It's a fair ball. One run, now they're saying foul ball. He surely looked like he motioned fair, but I guess not. Everybody else thought it was fair, too. Not that it was, but I'm just saying everybody thought it was. Three to three the score, and the pitch swinging a drive to right field. Right fielder comes in, and they make the catch. Good job. Good job of the right fielder out there. Thank you, Ronnie. Thank you, Sean Bullard out there with us, Janice Sappington. Belmont News Side, I think, is 2-2, they said. Toby Hall said he thought it was fair. So Gray flies out. That was Brennan Gray. This will be Eli rushing the first baseman. And the runner stealing the throw down there. And it's into right field. So the runner's going to score. The other runner will advance down to second base. And your Mooreville Troopers has taken a lead here. 4-3. Tish County scored three in the top of the first. Now Mooreville's come back to score four here in the bottom of the first. Tish County's helped out with some errors. And there's a pop-up to the outfield there. And the outfielder got it for the third out of the inning. But guess what? They strand a runner but score four, and we've played one inning. And it's already a 4-3 ball game on WRMG. New site and Belmont playing tonight. Belmont and East Union softball playing tonight. And, of course, Moreland and Red Bay softball was supposed to play tonight. It got canceled. But right now we've got Tishomingo County and Mooreville baseball going. There's Jayla Sage Brown out there with us. Thank you, Jayla. Do me a favor. We need everybody that's watching right now to share this broadcast. If you'll share it, we'll get some numbers up. And like I said, we got the biggest parts watching on the big screens. And, of course, I know we're up against some college basketball, I guess, tonight. Is that tonight? But these folks are here in big numbers watching the Braves and the Troopers. They like the hometown kits. Live coverage here from WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Thank you, Cream and Sugar, serving a full breakfast and lunch menu 7 to 3 daily. They're closed Tuesday and Wednesday. You can dine in or carry out, curbside, local delivery available. Online ordering available, 662-593-3498, or you can go to creamandsugarcafe.org and order online. And, yes, they do have dine-in, carry-out, curbside delivery as well. And there is a foul down the left field side. This is number 21 batting. We're back to the top of the batting order. Dylan Kirk as Tisch County batted through the first inning. And there's a strike. One ball, two strikes to Dylan Kirk, the leadoff batter. Dylan's a left-handed batter, and here's the pitch. Foul that one back to the screen. Also, big shout-out to Williams Pest Control and Insulation. That's Mr. Tyler Wooten, 454-3383. Needed in the walls or blown into the attic, they do it all, plus just general pest control. Termites. Been doing it for a long time. Has a ton of folks in Iuka and Tishomingo County. Has been using them for years. Thank you, Brandon Presley, our public service commissioner, on the job fighting to get internet service to every house in rural Mississippi. Thank you, Brandon. Boy, he's been busy, hasn't he? 2-2 with no out and the pitch on the way. And it is ball three. Appreciate Atkins Electrical and Plumbing Supply for all your electrical and plumbing needs. 424-9884 or 423-7660. And there is ball four, and the Braves get a leadoff walk. Four to three is your score. Blake counts the batter. You see down at the bottom of the screen, Mooreville leading Tishomingo County. Armistead on the mound, the right-hander, has hit 93 on the gun tonight. What grade's Mr. Armistead in? Senior. See, he decided where he's going to continue playing? ICC. Here's the 1-0 pitch with a runner at first base. Swing and a miss. Throw down to first. Runner back in safely down there. There's Ernestine Harrison checking in our broadcast. Thank you, Miss Ernestine. She's up in Nashville tonight. And strike three call. As counts is called out on strikes. This will bring up Spence Kaufman. Toby Hall said it looks good on YouTube. Thank you, Toby. And the pitch swinging, a drive to center field. Center fielder going back. And that one is out of here, folks. That is what you call a two-run homer for Spence Kaufman. Let's pick him up on the home run trot as a runner's coming home. There you see the runner coming home. And Tishomingo County Spence Kaufman takes that ball out to right center field and puts the Braves back on top. Spencer getting mauled on the way to the dugout. He gets the helmet there. You deserve the helmet when you do something like that, right? Three runs in the first, two here in the second. And the Braves now lead 5-4. There's a pop-up by Gage Tackett. Thank you, Lee Griffin, checking in with us. Lee, of course, there at Iuka Discount Drugs. Thank you, Mr. Lee. Oh, Dr. Cameron Buns, they know each other. Great baseball players for Tish County. Tim Arnold from Cartersville, Georgia, watching and enjoying the telecast. Betty Hill over in Ripley, Mississippi. Tish County is taking a 5-4 lead. A little slow roller back to the pitcher. Pitcher throws it over to first in time for the out. If you watch it on your cell phone, turn it over on the side and watch it full screen rather than up and down. We're broadcasting side to side to give you that full screen. Thank you, Carly Carmen, your attorney at 131 South Fulton in Iuka. 662-593-3079. And also big shout out to B&J's Grocery down in Burnsville, your hometown store supporting your hometown teams. Tish County has got a two-run homer from Spence Kaufman. And we've got two out, but we've scored two to take a 5-4 lead. Armistead, the right-hander, brings it to the plate. And he is going to be a foul ball. It hit him, but it hit the... They're bringing it back. There's a question here from Coach Marlin on what it actually hit. He's saying it hit his elbow protection, and the ump thought it hit his bat, and that's what's going to be the call. It hit his bat. They're going to call it a foul tip. So he's going to have to stay at the plate batting. There's Michael Borden checking in with us. Jackson Moore is the batter. Freshman third baseman for Tishomingo County. Batting with a 2-1 count. Hope you're enjoying our broadcast here today. And the swing and a shot to right field. And that is going to be an out. That'll be the third out of the inning. We've played an inning and a half. Tishomingo County has got 5 on the board. And the Mooreville Troopers has got 4 on the board. It's a 5-4 ball game live here in Mooreville tonight. All brought to you by Josh McNatt, your circuit court clerk. By Animals Choice Vet Clinic, Dr. Brad Nunley, Dr. Jennifer Tucker. You can call them at 423-2686. Captain Ryan Glover, Tishomingo County Sheriff's Department. By the Seegers Clinic, Dr. Scott Seegers, Nurse Practitioner Sarah Cooley, Jessica Glover, Blake McCauley. Call them at 423-1000 for an appointment. Also, Chad and all the staff at Harwell Parts, your CarQuest dealer, located at 1102 West Quitman in Iuka. Business hours are Monday through Friday, 7 to 5, open on Saturday, 7 to 12. Stop by and let Chad take care of all your parts and supply needs, 423-9892. Also, Hometown Pizza right here in Iuka on Battleground Drive. Regina James Smith owners, they may have us on the big screen tonight. They're open Monday through Sunday, 11 to 9, 7 days a week, folks. Whether it's pizza, pasta, salad bar, wings, baked potatoes, ice cream, or more, they got it at Hometown Pizza in Iuka. Don't forget to check out the location down in Burnsville, Mississippi. Appreciate you once again, Timothy Arnold and the crew in Cartersville, Georgia, watching tonight. Stevie Creekmore out there. I told you about Michael Gordon. The world-famous Dr. Cameron Buns at the North Mississippi Medical Center, Iuka. And the world-famous Lee Griffin, Kurt Butler. Of course, Iuka Discount Drugs. Thanks for a nice compliment there, Mr. Lee. Says he appreciates what you do, Jack. Well, I couldn't do it without wonderful sponsors like you, Mr. Lee. Shane Hutchison, there. We should have won it all in Mooreville in 98, but Bill Hall won it for Nettleton. Dude was a hoss. I remember my son graduated in 97, and he played against Bill Hall at Nettleton. And, of course, Nettleton's junior year there, I guess. And there's a drive to center field. Center fielder is under it to make the play for the out. This is number two, the batter. Jacob Scott, that was Luke Carpenter that flew out deep to center field. Jacob Scott is the shortstop. Yep, you're right, Mr. Shane Hutcherson there. One out, 5-4 Braves in the bottom of the second inning. One ball, one strike, one out. One of the fans from Mooreville just asked the umpire, could he see? I don't think he answered it, did he? I don't think the umpire answered the lady. She said, can you see? And the pitch on the way. And the pop-up to the right side. Second baseman coming over. And that ball is in there for a hit. Couldn't get to it, but it is a fair ball. I was doing a softball game the other day, and they was telling him not to quit his day job. Mason Gillentine, the batter here. He is the catcher for the ball club. Mooreville's got a runner down at first base with one out. We're in the bottom of the second inning. Tish County leads by a score of 5-4. Got three in the first, two in the second. And the runner stealing. And no throw by Tish County. There's Kathy and Kathy Allred Parsons checking in her broadcast. Big shout out to Prey Pottery and Heavenly Yogurt there in Iuka. Also, First American National Bank on a broadcast. What about Tia Boone, your Farm Bureau agent, 423-6151, Tishomingo County Electric Power on a broadcast, along with Northeast Mississippi Community College and Gatlin's Pharmacy down in Tishomingo, Mr. Stanley Page and the staff. And we got a time. The folks that have sent me messages that's watching on YouTube telling me how good it looks. If you haven't checked it out there, Lee, you might want to go to YouTube.com and just search Jack Ivey. You'll have to come back and tell me how good, but tell me how good it looks on YouTube. YouTube.com, just search Jack Ivey as there's a foul back. You'll see my picture, click on it, and you'll see where we're live, click on it, and you'll have it in high definition live here in the big city of Mooreville, 5-4 Tish County. Two balls, two strikes, and one out. Mason Gillentine batting with a runner down at second. And he's stealing third. And he's going to steal third without a throw. So he stole two bases without a throw from Tish County. 3-2, he got that good a jump. Thanks once again to Prey Pottery Heavily Yogurt, 0202. Thank you, Tia Boone, once again. And there is a shot to left field. Left fielder going back. And that one is off of the bottom of the wall. He's going to be standing down at second base with an RBI double. And an exciting RBI double for the Mooreville Troopers here. They've tied this game up. I guess we better put another run up on the board for the ball club. For Mooreville, 5-5. People wanted the money's worth on senior night. I didn't want to stay all night. I mean, I like you folks in Mooreville, but I... J.W. Armistead. I'll say it where they can hear me. Y'all folks are awesome. We appreciate y'all. Great hospitality. Makes the Ivy Man feel welcome, and I appreciate that. I don't take that lightly there. And the pitch on the way. Tishomingo County and Mooreville. Yeah, the facilities looks great there, Shane. It's the field looks awesome. And the pitch on the way. There's world famous Terry James out there checking in. Hey, Terry. Peyton Cummings, your Tishomingo County Chancery Clerk on the broadcast. Iuka Discount Drugs at 1411 West Equipment Street, Iuka. Call them at 423-9039 to speak with pharmacist Lee Griffin or Kurt Butler. They're wonderful folks at Iuka. We got a timeout. Of course, talking about the world-famous folks at Iuka Discount Drugs, they offer the ultimate prescription management solution. With their free one-pack program, they also offer free delivery, vaccines, and a 340B prescription savings program. A lot to offer right there under one roof. Thank you, Mr. Lee. And there is a strike call. One ball, two strikes. Runner down at second. With one out, we're all tied 5-5. And the pitch swing, and that ball is hit to the right side. And he slipped down and misplayed it. And here comes another run across the plate. And he'll end up over at third base. I thought it was going to be a routine catch out there, and it looked like he fell down. And Armistead will have a courtesy runner at first base. I guess we need to see who that courtesy runner is. 6-5 is your score. So Mooreville is on top. We'll check that courtesy runner there, see if he'll. And the pitch on the way, inside. Mason McMillan. I believe that is Keegan Weathersby, the courtesy runner down at first base. I may know Keegan. And the pitch on the way. Swing. And a pop to the right side. Right fielder coming over. And he drops that one. So another runner is going to score. And the runner down at second base. He didn't actually drop it. Just misplayed it and it hit the ground there. I wouldn't want to be wanting to catch him out there this time of night. So now that makes it a 7-5 ball game. As Mooreville has scored three here in the second. Tish County got three in the first, two in the second to put them back up 5-4. And now Mooreville with the one out's got a runner at second. And this is number 24, Judd Fowles. You know this, kiddo? Is this yours? One ball, no strikes, and one out. Runner at second. Judd Fowles ready to go. The pitch is low and inside. He is the center fielder. His dad played right here at Mooreville, and you played at ICC, or where, you played at Etowamba High School and at ICC. I just assumed you played here. And the pitch on the way. And the shot is a foul. What position did you play? Outfielder and a pitcher. Does Judd pitch any? So following in Dad's footsteps. Two balls and one strike, one out. 7-5, more of a lead here in the bottom of the second inning. And the pitch, swing and a shot. Third baseman's got it. He's going to try to run the guy down and tags him out. No, not tag. He's still in a rundown. Let's see if Tisch County can get him out. And they do, but the runner advances down to second. Fouls. So he's safe at second base, but now there's two outs as Tisch County got the lead runner. There's Sandra Tidwell with us out there. Hey, Miss Sandra. Marky Pomeroy. Two outs. This is Taylor Hussey, the left fielder. Mooreville has fought back to take a 7-5 lead here in the bottom of the second inning. Got a timeout there. And the pitch, ball high, runners. Stealing there without a throw. Tonight's broadcast brought to you by Casey Lott, your attorney at the largest personal injury law firm. He owns that place. Thank you, Mr. Casey Lott. Ball got away, but runner going to stay down at third. With attorneys licensed in Mississippi, Alabama, and Tennessee, Casey and his team of attorneys specialize in personal injury. Also, pharmaceutical product liability cases. Call Casey for all your legal needs. And, of course, Casey does a wonderful job. Appreciate you, Casey, a lot. Three balls, no strikes, two outs, runner at third. Swing on a 3-0 pitch, and it's a base hit right up the middle. That will score a run, and he's safely down at first base. Setting on that one, had the green light, and that might be all four pitchers. We got an 8-5 lead right here. Still only two outs. Eight to five, Mooreville, and they've scored four in the first and four in the second. This is live coverage from WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. That is going to be all for Ashton Brown. We'll see who comes on to pitch for Tishomingo County. And he's giving the ball to looks like number seven. Number seven is going to be your new pitcher, and that is Mason James. We saw Mason pitch, I guess, either against Amory or Oxford. I believe it might have been against Oxford over at Corinth. Jack Ivey live for WRMG TV 12 and TV 97. Today's game brought to you by Northeast Mississippi Community College. 1-800-555-2154. They got that wonderful Student Success Center with a workforce training with a commitment to excellence in athletics and a four-day instructional work week featuring online short-term hybrid classes, all at affordable prices. 1-800-555-2154. And also, don't forget today's broadcast brought to you by Peyton Cummings, your Chancery Clerk. I told you about Iuka Discount Drugs, Lee Griffin and Kirk Butler. What about David Wayne Crum, your Tishomingo County Tax Assessor? By Mid-South Rehab at the North Mississippi Medical Center, Iuka, 423-4058. Call for an appointment today. Also, Mac Wyom in your Tishomingo County Corner. And by Nunley Trucking Company, all on a broadcast here today. I'm Jack Ivey, live for WRMG TV 12 and TV 97. This is the Ivey Broadcasting Company. We'll be right back. So new pitcher, Mason James. Vernon Gray, the batter. Runner down at first. And there is a pop to the left side of the infield. Out of play. Brennan Gray, he's the right fielder for the ball club from Mooreville. They lead now 8-5 over Tish County. There's another pop-up. That one's going to be out of play. Make sure we got our scoreboard right. It is 8-5. One ball, two strikes, and the pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. Got away from the catcher. Throw down to first for the third out of the inning. Folks, we'll see you show you the scoreboard. It's a long way off, but there you see Mooreville. Tish County got three in the first, two in the second. Mooreville got four in the first, four in the second, and lead 8-5. Over the Tishomingo County Braves. I'm Jack Ivey live in Mooreville. We're going to go to the top of the third inning on this, the Ivey Broadcasting Company. It is senior night here in Mooreville, and they were recognized before the game tonight, so congratulations to all the seniors that was recognized here tonight. This is WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97, the Ivey Broadcasting Company. Also on a broadcast today is Plaza Lane's Premier Bowling Alley in Corinth, 2001 East Shiloh Road. And, of course, somebody asked about do they have, like, leagues for all skill levels? Well, if you're really, really good, they got levels. If you're just starting out, they got leagues for that as well. So they'll try to put you in there where you'd be competitive. 286-8105 gets you Plaza Lane's. Also, big shout-out by the Belmont Medical Clinic for the best medical care for you and your family member. It's worth a drive from even Mooreville up there. 454-3401. Heather does a wonderful job. Her name is Heather Edmondson. Husband is Shannon, and they got a great staff there, and they really appreciate your business. Belmont Medical. Also, Hometown Pizza in Burnsville, and also in the big city of Iuka, all on a broadcast here today. Also, Triple D's Bucket Service, Barney Brandon and Dustin Dick, 279-7500. Burnsville Tire with Mr. Ethan Morris, 427-9308 is the number there for Burnsville Tire. This is number 12 batting. Chandler Williams. Thank you, folks, for joining us. Send me a message. Let me know how we're looking and sounding. Always like some feedback throughout the broadcast. Make sure everything's still looking and sounding good. But thank you for being out there. other words, send me a message right now, and all you people that are watching on Facebook, make sure you share it. We're on Twitter and Twitch as well, plus YouTube. A strikeout, and he's going to be out. So the first out of the inning here in the top of the third. Swing, batter, batter. Ashton Brown, he is going to bat, swing and a miss. He started out pitching, gave away to Mason James last inning. And the pitch on the way. Eight to five. Mooreville leading over Tish County. Tish County fouls and tips that one. J.W. Armistead still on the mound pitching. And the Armistead pitch on the way. Swing and a shot. Third baseman knocks it down. He's got time, throws to first. Got away from the first baseman, and he'll have to stay there. That one was in the dirt. Had time to throw him out, but maybe rushed it a little bit. And the runner will be safely down at first base. So Brown will be safe down there. Chase Hopkins will be the batter. Jason Reaper checking out our broadcast. Thank you, Jason. Three runs in the first, two in the second for Tish County. That's their five runs. Four in the first, four in the second for Mooreville. They lead 8-5. Tish County with one out. Fouls that one back. Got a runner at first, 1-1 count to the batter. Chase Hopkins. And the pitch, swing and a miss. And the strikeout there be the second out of the inning. Mason James now the batter. He's batting with two out with a one strike count. Still a runner at first base. Another strike. Oh, balls, no balls and two strikes. K Count now, one ball, two strikes, and two outs. We're in the top of the third, 8-5, Mooreville leads. And there is strike three call as James is called out on strikes. He'll head back to the mound for Tishomingo County. This is WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. I'm Jack Ivey live. Thank you, First American National Bank, for making this game possible here today. Of course, locations all over the county, four locations, but many throughout North Mississippi. We're mainly talking about the wonderful locations in Tishomingo County here tonight. But don't forget, as always, First American National Bank loves these teams out here, and First American National Bank, customers driven and community focused since 1964. Also at First American National Bank, you'll get that hometown feel with a high-tech touch. They've really stepped up the game big time when it comes to technology at First American National Bank. Also, big shout out today to Triple D's Bucket Service. I told you about Burnsville Tire. I wanted to tell you some more. They stock a variety of passenger and light truck tires, top brands including Mastercraft, Firestone, Goodyear. They also got the specialty tires taken care of. You need to get that everything done. Choose from farm, ATV, lawn and garden, or commercial tires, even the toughest vehicles. Visit our Burnsville Tire repair location in Burnsville. Get back on the road, 427-9308. Mason James still on the mound pitching for the Braves. Brought to you by Sonic and Iuka, Sonic and Belmont, and New Albany. Largest soft drinks are your morning drink stop. Large soft drinks are only 99 cents. Thank you, Mr. John Kane. And is Eli batting here for Mooreville as we go to the bottom of the third? Maybe we can get this game moving on a little bit. This is Eli rushing. Seems like it's lasted a while here. Let's see, we're over an hour in, and we haven't played three innings yet. There's a swing and a foul. Glad to have Brittany Gable Sparks back with us, Josh Raper, Toby Hall. Remember, if you're joining us on a broadcast, make sure you share this. I was hoping you'd let me know what it looked like and sounded like, but I ain't heard from very many, so I don't know what that means. What's Mr. James throwing? How about 73 on that one? Three balls and one strike. Armistead for Mooreville hit 93 earlier tonight. And the pitch. And it's ball four. There's old Shane Hutcherson setting it, sounding good out there. And also, Amy Cooley Dotson said, let's go Braves, looking good, Jack. Live coverage here. Looks like we're going to have a courtesy runner heading down to first base. Number seven is going to head down there. That's Will Carnathan. No wind tonight. Flags are not moving. There's Gavin Lynch checking with us. Chad Nunley. Number one, the batter here. Luke Carpenter, the third baseman, lays down a bunt. Nicely done. Pitcher's got it. Throws to first. In time with the out. Good job there, Mason. There's Sean Bullard out there with us. Thank you, Sean. Number two, as we head back to the top of the batting order. Folks, this is Jacob Scott, the shortstop. Mason Gillendine will be on deck. J.W. Armistead, if anything happens. Live coverage from the Ivy Broadcasting Company. We're live in Mooreville tonight. And the pitch, laying down another bunt. That one's going to be a hit all the way. You can be assured, not won't even be a throw on that one. What a bunt there. They do the little things right here in Mooreville. This will bring up the next batter. He's number three, Mason Gillendine, coming up. Got a lot of folks. I was looking down in the stands, and a lot of folks got their phones out checking through. Saw a couple folks watching the game from down there. Of course, there's a little delay in the action, so that's probably going to throw them off a little bit. But you folks in Mooreville, for sure, make sure you share this. When we got a ball. And another run's going to score. So Mooreville continues to add to the lead. They got a 9-5 lead. Well, we got a break in the action. Mooreville with one out, got a 1-0 count, and they've added another run. They lead 9-5 here in Mooreville. We'll take a break. We'll be right back. This is Tishomingo County and Mooreville Baseball on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. One ball, no strike, and one out. 9-5 Mooreville, and the pitch gets away from the catcher. Runner will stay down at third. Mason Gillendine, the batter. J.W. Armistead is on deck. He's the pitcher. Mooreville, four runs in the first, four in the second, one here in the third. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a shot to right field. Right fielder going back is under it and makes the catch. And the runner will tag up and come home. Armistead will bat. As number two, Jacob Scott came home and scored. So now that makes it 10-5. Hits that down the third base side. Got a good bounce on that one. And he is going to be out at first base for the third out. Kind of a close play down there, but able to make it. So we've played three complete. It is 10-5 is your score. I'm Jack Ivey live for WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Thank you, Jason Rayburn. Said he wished more schools and areas would do this and promote high school athletics more. Nice to be able to watch a game. Jason, I've been doing, not by myself, I've got a wonderful crew. We do Belmont, we do Tishomingo County, and we also do Red Bay, Alabama. We do every football game and have for the last 20 years and put them on television. We do the biggest majority of the basketball games, and we kind of split up between baseball and softball each school because then you got, instead of three teams, you got six different teams, so we try to do several of those as well and try to do a good job quality wise but I can tell you why most of them don't do it. It's a lot of work, and it's a lot of work, I promise you that. Thank you, Sonic in Belmont. Now Yuka, your morning drink stop. Large soft drinks are 99 cents. Happy hour, of course, is 2 to 4 daily. Half price soft drinks, slushies, teas. Download that Sonic app, you can save some additional money. 454-3070 in Belmont, and Iuka 423-9100. Also, if you're down around New Albany, they own that Sonic in New Albany as well. Appreciate Piggly Wiggly, lowest prices, hometown friendly service. And, of course, you got that buffet at lunch. And they got the wonderful Ace Hardware. Got a new inning coming up, top of the fourth, all brought to you by Ronnie Cook, your modern woman agent, 423-8477 is the number. Once again, 423-8477, modern woman, touching lives, securing futures. Also, big shout-out to Sid's Trading Company, your Branson dealer, Bushog Zero Turn More dealer, and much, much more. And plus, you're dealing with a world-famous man himself, Mr. Sid Whiters. It's definitely worth the drive. Folks do it all the time, drive from a long way off to deal with Sid's Trading Company. He'll save you some money. Blake Council will be your batter. Armistead still on the mound, and there's the pitch. Swing and a foul. Two balls and a strike. It's not counts. That's his Dylan Kirk. I'm sorry. Dylan Kirk. I saw the two but didn't see the one. Two-one count, and the pitch on the way. Swing and a shot. Third baseman knocks it down, picks up, throws to first. For the out, score that one 5-3. So once again, thank you, Jason. Speaking of Blake Counts, he is batting next. Blake playing out in right field today. And the pitch. Swing and a foul tip. Thank you, First American National Bank, on the broadcast. You can see Miss Brenda Kennedy down in Burnsville or see Aaron Holt down in Iuka. Iuka Animal Clinic, Dr. James Perkins, along with A&W Septic Tank Service. See Jimmy, 424-9884. Also, your full-service plumbing company is A&W. One ball, one strike, one out, and the pitch on the way. Swing and another foul. One ball, two strikes, and one out. 10-5, more of a lead. You see that at the bottom of the screen. Armstead is still hitting 90. Hit 93 earlier. And there's the pitch. Second baseman. Over to first in time. Score that one 4-3. Spence Kaufman got him a two-run homer in the second inning to put the Braves back out on top. They were up 3-0 and down 4-3, and that put them up 5-4, but that didn't last long as Mooreville picked up four in the bottom of the second, two more in the bottom of the third. They lead 10-5 right now. Want top-notch internet in Tishomingo County? Got your location, Tishomingo Connect. 423-3646. They're bringing it to every single household in Tishomingo County. So if you want high-speed internet and you're not on the list, need to get on there. Thank you, Brooks Grocery. Download the Brooks app. And, of course, it's available on the App Store and Google Play. Shop online. They'll bring your groceries even out to your car. It's that easy. A lot of folks need that service, and they offer it at Brooks. There's the world-famous Riley Floyd with us. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a ground ball. Shortstop's got it. Throws first in time of the out. That'll retire the side. We're going to go to the bottom of the fourth inning. 10-5, it's right now the Mooreville Troopers leading. We'll take a break and we'll be right back. This is the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Batting here in the bottom of the fourth inning, McMillan will lead it off. His first pitch inside from James. And a swing, foul ball. One ball, one strike. Nobody out here in the bottom of the fourth. Talking about Brooks Grocery, they're proudly owned and operated there since 2009. And there's a base hit to left field. More than a base hit. He's heading over to third as that ball gets away out there. What a hit there. Kind of had me blinded there by that pole. I couldn't see 100%. There's Christy Glidewell checking in with us. Riley Floyd. Hey, Riley. So, Mooreville now with a runner at third and nobody out. They already lead 10-5. They got four in the first, four in the second, and two in the third. And threatening already here in the third inning, or fourth inning, I should say. Judd Fowles now the batter. Judd is the center fielder. Outstanding ball player for these Mooreville Troopers. And there's a shot to the left side. Shortstop not able to make the throw over there. Now the ball gets away. So Braves help him out again. He made the long throw over there. It got away. It was offline. And somehow or another it got away. And Judd ends up down at second base. Infield hit and an error on the Braves. But he'll get the hit there. Christy Glidewell checking in with us along with Michelle Ramsey James. All on the broadcast of Tisch County Braves Sports here. Of course, Tisch County Braves Sports is brought to you by Christy and all the wonderful folks down at B&J's down in Burnsville. What wonderful specials they got each and every week. And, of course, Christy likes to say, your hometown store supporting hometown teams. And I want you to make sure you tell Christy and all the folks down at B&J's in Burnsville how much you appreciate them bringing baseball, softball, basketball, football. If we're broadcasting any sports for Tishomingo County, we appreciate B&J's for being one of our sponsors. Regular season, playoffs, thank you all so much. And hopefully it looks good wherever you're watching tonight, Christy. Another run on the board makes it 11-5. Left-handed batter here. Taylor Hussey. And the pitch is a strike call. One ball, one strike. Nobody out. One run in here in the fourth. And there's a shot to the right side. Another base hit, and that will score. Nope. Well, he slipped and fell down. And he'll have to go back. Made the turn there coming to the plate. Slipped down, so he decided to go ahead and go back. So now a runner at first and third at number 11 now, the batter. Brennan Gray, there's Mike Owens checking in with us. Michelle Ramsey James, told you about Christy Glidewell joining us here. We got a lot of folks watching on YouTube. We got them on Facebook. We got them on Twitter. Also Twitch and also WRMG Live. One ball, no strikes, bottom of the fourth inning, and one run is in for Mooreville. They lead 11-5. Got a runner at first and third right now with nobody out. Runner will steal. They throw back to the pitcher. Appreciate A&W Septic Tank Service and also your full-service plumbing company at 307 Constitution Drive. Call Jimmy, 424-9884. All at affordable prices, of course. And the pitch on the way. Ball low. Mason James on in relief from Ashton Brown, who started for Tish County tonight. Don't forget Williams Service Center, Mr. Todd Williams. 11-12 West Quitman. Another ball, three balls and a strike. About to load them up. Next batter is number 8, Eli Rushing, the first baseman. Here's the 3-1 pitch. Remember, nobody out. And there's ball four. So big hitter here on the right side of the plate for Mooreville. Appreciate Dr. Cameron Buns at the North Mississippi Medical Center, Iuka, to schedule an appointment. 423-6014, Dr. Buns and his family and staff want to wish all the teams good luck. There's a foul ball. Also on our broadcast today is Williams Pest Control Insulation, Mr. Tyler Wooten, 454-3383. Blown in insulation, they'll put it in the attic. Just general pest control as well. Ball inside on the curve. Thank you, Cream and Sugar Cafe, serving a full breakfast, lunch menu 7 to 3. Closed on Tuesday and Wednesday. You can call them at 662-593-3498. And of course, they do deliver. And the pitch, strike call. One ball, two strikes. Nobody out. The bases are loaded. Also, Tishomingo County Tax Collector Gina Macnett. And the strikeout. Runner's coming home, and he's going to score easily. Of course, a runner going to first. Strikes out, and of course, first base was occupied. So, what do they call him? He is going to be out, and the runners advance to second and third, and that'll make it 12. 12-5 now with one out. This will be number one, the batter, Luke Carpenter. 12-5. With one out. And the 1-0 pitch, swing and a shot down the line. It is a fair ball. One run is in. Two runs are in. He's going to hold up down at first base, but drives in two runs. And we'll get those runs on the board here in a minute. Great job there by Luke Carpenter. We'll be back to the top of the batting order. Jacob Scott, the shortstop, will bat. Fourteen to five, the score. Mooreville has been hot. They scored four in the first, four in the second, two in the third, and four here in the bottom of the fourth. So they've scored four in the first, four in the second, two in the third, four in the fourth. Braves got three in the first and two in the second. Fourteen to four, runner down at first base, and one out. Two balls and no strikes with one out. Mason Gillentine batting here with a 2-0 count. And there's a shot right by the third baseman going down to the corner. Here comes a run over into third. And guess where the batter is? He's down at second base. 14-5 now with the runners at second and third. And that's probably going to be all there is for Mr. Mason James. Nobody has come close to slowing down this Mooreville lineup. They got four in the first, four in the second, two in the third, and four here in the fourth, lead 14-5. Shane Hutcherson there says, good night. This one is in the books. Hail Troopers. Thank you, Shane, for watching tonight, okay? We'll see who the new pitcher is in just a minute. I'm Jack Ivey live for WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Thank you, Brandon Presley, your public service commissioner on the broadcast tonight. Atkins Electrical Plumbing Supply, 424-9884 or 423-7660 for all your electrical plumbing needs. Also, Carly Carmen, your attorney, small firm with a big heart. And, of course, Illinois, they got estate, real estate law, business law, adoptions, estate planning, nonprofit and charity formation. You can visit us at nextdoorlawyer.com. Number 26 is going to be your new pitcher, and that is going to be Blaine Sparks. Lila Grace Sanderson, thank you for being out there. We're going to take a break. It's 14-5, Mooreville leading. This is the Ivy Broadcasting Company. We'll be right back. Richard. Thank you once again to B&J's Grocery, Highway 365, Burnsville on a broadcast tonight, along with Captain Ryan Glover, Tishomingo County Sheriff's Department, and by Animals Choice Vet Clinic on a broadcast. 1-0 count with a one out. Runner at second and third. Down at second, he's got a monster lead down there. Wild pitch. But the runners will stay there. And the pitch on the way. It's high. Guess I need to tell you who's batting here. This is Keegan Weathersby. I know some Weathersbys. I knew. I don't know where this related to who I'm thinking about. Mike Owens is watching, so I may be right. There's Keegan. They got the light off in the press box, so it's kind of hard to see my roster there. But I'll give you a good shot up the world-famous Keegan there. Clint Wilmoth out there. You see he's going to get him a big lead. We'll better get it back here to the batter. Bases are loaded with one out. J.W. Armistead batting here. He's got a 14-5 lead. He gave up three runs in that first inning, two in the second. He settled down and took back control of the ball game. He's at a Wauma Community College commitment signee. There's a pop-up a mile high. And the catcher cannot make the catch. So the Braves was that close of getting their second out. Hey, Jared L. Gray out there, Clint Wilmoth. Mooreville's got the bases loaded here in the bottom of the fourth inning. They lead 14-5, and here's the pitch on the way. Swing, pop and foul back out of play. And a ball. Two balls and two strikes. Live coverage from the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Belmont played East Union softball tonight. Don't even want to tell you that score. It was real bad. East Union winning. And the pitch on the way. Ball outside. 3-2. Nowhere to put this guy. Blaine Sparks on the mound pitching. He's the third pitcher of the night for Tisch County. And here's the 3-2 pitch. Ball four. Walked him, and here's another run coming in. Moving on up. It's now 15-5, the score. And this will bring up number 12. Mason McMillan. This one getting out of hand, isn't it, folks? Jack Ivey will be needing to go home and take a nap. 15-5, Mooreville. And the pitch on the way. Hope you're enjoying the broadcast. I know the Mooreville folks are enjoying it more than the Tishomingo County folks, but we try to bring you a good broadcast, and hopefully you've enjoyed it. One ball, one strike, and the pitch gets away. Runners at first, second, and third. One ball, one strike, one out. Bases loaded for this young man here. And the pitch on the way. Swing, and he got one. And that's a base hit to left field. That's going to score two more runs. There's one coming in, two coming in. And there he is down at first base with another base hit. Put two more runs on the board. And, folks, that makes it 17-5. That young man right there, number 12, Mason McMillan, got the hit to drive in two runs. They'll have runners at first and second now. For number 24, the batter, Judd Fowles. Had a chance to talk with Judd's dad up here tonight. And Judd gets a hold of one and takes that ball deep. And it's out of here. I was trying to find it, finally found it. And Judd just hit him a two-run homer. He makes it around the track. And that's going to make it, I believe, 20-5. What a hit by Judd Fowles for the Mooreville Troopers as he steps on the bag. The rest of the team waiting on him. And a great hit there by Judd Fowles, taking that one deep out in left center field. 20-5 is the score. Tishomingo County has not had an answer for anything that Mooreville's put out of here tonight. So Mooreville now leads 20-5. Did you have that camera going 90-0? Did you make a lot of pictures on that one? 20-5 the score. This will bring up Taylor Hussey. No, ma'am, I did not do the JV. I couldn't get here in time for that one. But we normally do the varsity. The school really supposed to be doing, not JV on the road, but the home games, the school's supposed to be doing JV stuff. We're just really supposed to do. I guess you could say, a handful of them if we can. And we have done some. But we didn't do this one tonight to answer your question. We will, if the weather permits, we'll be doing the Belmont and Tisch County game Saturday. We'll do the varsity and JV Saturday for sure. I just told you, Miss Harwell, I didn't get here in time. We don't do all the JVs. We're really just supposed to be doing the varsity, but we've done a few JV games. So I apologize on that. Two balls, two strikes, one out. And nobody on as Fowles clear the bases. And the pitch on the way. So that'll be the second out of the inning. This will bring up number 11, Brennan Gray. The pitch on the way. It's a ball. That is ball four. Or it hit him, I guess it did. This will bring up number eight batting next. This is Eli Rushing. Live coverage here from WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. A runner down at first with two out. And the pitch is high. There's Sparks on the mound pitching for Tishomingo County. And a strike call. And another hit. That one's going to be deep. And that one there is going to be caught by the center fielder to retire the side. He took that one for a pretty good ride. And the Braves finally get out of the inning. But it's now 20-5 the score. 20-5 the score. Braves will probably have one more opportunity. So we're live on WRMG TV 12 and also Television 97. Once again, congratulations. And thanks to all of our wonderful sponsors here today, including the Seegers Clinic. Thank you, Dr. Scott, Sarah Cooley, Jessica Glover, Blake McCauley, for an appointment, 423-1000. Harwell Parts and Service, thank you, Chad, and all the staff at 423-9892. They take care of all your parts needs. Business hours Monday through Friday. They're open 7 in the morning till 5 in the afternoon on Saturday, 7 to 12. Your CarQuest dealer located 1102 West Quitman in Iuka. Once again, it's Harwell Parts and Supply. Sponsoring Tishomingo County Brave Sports here on WRMG. Also, big shout out today to Captain Ryan Glover of the Tishomingo County Sheriff's Department, saying good luck to the Braves tonight. Animals Choice Vet Clinic, Brad Nunley, Dr. Jennifer Tucker, good luck to the Braves. Also, from Hometown Pizza right here in Iuka, and also down in the big city of Burnsville. There's Justin Parsons checking into our broadcast. Justin, if you just joined us, you see on the scoreboard, not a good night, late night. Started off, Braves scored three runs in the first, led 3-0. But what happened was they gave up four in the first, four in the second, two in the third, and 10 runs in the fourth, and trail 20-5. New pitcher, the left-hander on the mound. This is Caden Carroll, the new pitcher. Catcher for the Braves now batting, Mr. Tackett. Last opportunity, I guess, for the Braves here in the top of the fifth inning. They're down 20-5. Thank you once again, Mr. Jason Raper out there, and Shane Hutcherson out there, Justin Parsons. Thank you so much. Thank you, Miss Shelley Harwell. Two strikes to count. And we got a timeout here. Well, the top of the first looked good for the Braves. They scored three runs and gave up four in the bottom. looked okay after the inning and a half. Braves were up 5-4. Since then, they have scored 16 runs and lead 20-5 over the Braves. Carroll's ready to go, the left-hander. He'll bring it to the plate. And strike three call. Got him on the corner there. This will bring up number 22 for the Braves. Jackson Moore. Only a ninth grader, third baseman, and the pitch on the way. Ball outside. Thank you, one to Gatlin's Pharmacy in Tishomingo, 438-6605. Pre-Pottery and Heavily Yogurt downtown. Thank you, Tishomingo County Electric Power. Tia Boone, your Farm Bureau agent. Northeast Mississippi Community College, also Casey Lott, your attorney. Peyton Cummings, your Chancellor Clerk. Iuka Discount Drugs, Lee Griffin. Thank you, David Wayne Crum, Mid-South Rehab. Mac Wom and your Tishomingo County Corner. And Nunley Trucking Company, all on our broadcast. And there is ball four to Jackson Moore. Chandler Williams, the DH now, the batter, batting with one out and a runner down at first. And the pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. And the pitch. Swing and a foul tip. Two strikes, the count here. And the pitch on the way. Strike three call, second out of the inning. So the Braves got one more out. Ashton Brown, he started the game tonight, gave away to Mason James, and then Sparks came on. And the pitch, high and in tight. Caden Carroll come on to close it out here for Mr. J.W. Armistead. One-oh count. With two outs, and there's the pitch. It's a ball low. Two balls and no strikes, and the pitch on the way. 3-0 now. Thank you, Jayla Sage Brown, out there checking in on our broadcast. We had a lot of folks that's been with us all night. Braves fans, I wish I had you better news. I know the fans from Mooreville, they're loving it. They're up 20-5 here in the top of the fifth, and there is a strike call. We're going to get out of here in a hurry whenever it's called here. And the pitch on the way. Ball four. Got another base runner. Runners at first and second now. Double checking that number. Chase Hopkins. Batting with runners at first and second, two out. We'd have to bat for a long time to get back in this one. We're down 20-5. Even if we scored 10 like they did last inning. So I think we're going to ease out of here and play again another day. We're down 20-5. Just hadn't had it tonight. Swing and a miss. Thank you again for joining us here tonight on WRMG. Thank you, Hometown Pizza, Burnsville, Iuka, Belmont Medical Clinic, Heather Edmondson, Tiffin Motor Homes, and also Plaza Bowling Lanes, Premier Bowling Lanes over in Corinth. Carly Carmen, your attorney at law, and there's the strike call. Thank you, First American National Bank, Burnsville Tire, Triple D's Bucket Service, Sonic and Belmont Iuka, Piggly Wiggly, Runny Cook, Sid's Trading Company, all on a broadcast. And folks, that is your old ball game right there. As the Braves strike out, and there you see it right there, 20-5 is going to be your final score. I told you we was going to get out of here in a hurry, didn't I? So there's your winning team tonight, the Mooreville Troopers. Thanks once again for the hospitality, Mooreville. And we'll see you next time on a diamond close to you. Once again, that wraps up our broadcast. Mooreville knocks off Tishomingo County tonight. The final score is 20-5. I'll say good night. May God bless you. Thank you, Mr. Pete Howell, joining us. Brother Pete, we're going to ease on out here. The Braves lose it to Mooreville, 20-5. They got four in the first, four in the second, two in the third, and 10 in the fourth. Didn't have to bat here in the bottom of the fifth. Win it 20-5. We've got three in the first and two in the second. That's where our runs came. I'm going to say good night. We'll see you next time here. Thanks to our wonderful sponsors, and thank you for joining us here tonight on the Ivy Broadcasting Company. Good night, everybody.